Star Wars fans, FlyGuy for FlyGuy.net. Another Star Wars Black Series 3.75-inch figure review. This time, Commander Wolf. In his brief blink again and you'll miss it, Clone Wars kind of scenario or outfit. We get to see this guy very, very briefly in a scene with Plo Koon in the Clone Wars, and this is basically how the figures, where the figure is based from. Number 12 in the line. And a great looking figure, this brand new sculpt. As far as I can tell, just about everything is brand new on this figure, so really nice and refreshing to get something new and different. So there we go, there's all the yada yada text, a little snapshot of them there. There we go, that's pretty much it. And a little snippet of Disney and the Hasbro logo there. If you want to pre-order and get this guy, he's been up for pre-order for a long time. He is just about to ship. This was a couple of cases that Dark Side Toys got in. A little couple of dings there on the packaging. Couldn't ship that out, unfortunately. People just will not accept that. So, or some people will not accept that. So that this is why this got a review. But they are coming soon. If you want to pick them up, click the link directly underneath and you will get one. And I recommend you get this guy. He's a very good looking figure. So on with this guy. Let me give him a good close up and let's go around and talk about the figure itself. Really nice kind of Macquarie-esque design going on this guy. The helmet just looks particularly sharp and good. Lots of kind of zigzag patterns. Looks great from the side there. Even the little accentuated colour, the yellow. Just down to the kind of breathing apparatus, just looks really good. I love the texture. You can just see it on his stomach there, the kind of ripples of the uniform just in there. Just allows the figure to just have that bit more realistic kind of style, as if the padding and the quilting was moving along with him. So it looks particularly good. How good does that Wolfpack logo look? In case you didn't know, I do a weekly show with the Wolfpack podcast, or roughly every week, and a great bunch of guys they are. Join me, Dan Curto, Yakface, Corey, Dan, Marco, did I say Dan there twice? Chris, tons of people, literally, Nabil, lots of great guys on there on a weekly show, and we discuss some Star Wars, so Google that out, the Wolfpack podcast. Great fun and entertainment is had. So that helmet is really all Wolfpack-like designs there. You can see all the little emblems, the way it's been put together. But real Macquarie-esque design, as I said, of the Snowtroopers. Just love that. And this is what this figure is really all about, I think, is these cool designs and transfers. So that's enough of me showing you that and all the designs on them. On the back, we've got removable Snowtrooper-esque little backpack going on there. And you can see that plugged into the back there, the little peg, little simple white peg going on. Do like that. And a little hexagonal hole on his back for that. Also comes with a great working holster. Looks as if it's about to just pop out there at the back. Let me just plug that in a little bit more. That made no difference. There's the holsters there for the pistols, which we'll see in a minute. Working holsters, again, great to see this back. And a little antenna on his shoulder, a la Commander Cody. So if we pop that back up that way, that looks a little better there, rather than it kind of jolting out the back. But yeah, looks very, very good indeed. Nice little touches, it's got this cloth camo. Unlike some of the other figures like Rex, for example, where we had a plastic camo, this one just looks great. And I love that little fabric, the little dimpled piece in the fabric. This just shows you, I mean, Hasbro do, a lot of people just give Hasbro such a hard time sometimes. Yes, I know they're not perfect, but this is a 3.75-inch scale figure, again, made by people in China who really probably don't get anywhere near what you get for a wage. So, and they ship it overseas, and logistics and printing and packaging and so forth. So I think it's a pretty good deal to get some good figures like this now and again. I really do. I'm impressed by some of this stuff. Again, at the scale, it's very intricate. Peg holes down at the bottom, but just really nice design overall on this figure. Let me just lift that up so you can see a little more of Wolf Bum. But again, love that little dimply quilted figure. The sequence on the Clone Wars, I think it was a very cold planet from memory, and hence this is almost a very early prototype Snowtrooper-like get-up. Some nice little touch of little ammo pouches there up at the top as well. And you can see these blasters. We've had these many times before. Very simple, straightforward. What a nice touch that would have been. Again, to add some chrome there, Hasbro, that would have just made this thing look like a weapon instead of just a black blob of plastic. But it does the job, and if you really want to do it, you could almost do that yourself. But they're pretty good blasters, and he holds them pretty well in both hands if you want to. In terms of articulation, he's packing it. Great, flexible kind of head. Yes, he's nodding. Yes, I'm very articulated. So plenty of movement there on that ball joint. Ball joint with a hinge on the shoulders. Down at the elbows, you get the same again. You can see the little hinge there. We've got swivel wrists up there. There is no extra movement. Is there? Oh, there is. Fantastic. I couldn't see that there because of the white. Am I imagining things? No, I'm not. I think I am imagining things, actually. No, I might be wrong. It's just brand new and the plastic's really hard. You can just see it there. It's so difficult to see in the camera. There is articulation in those wrists there. Double pivoting kind of articulation you can see up at the top there too. Very hard to see, but it basically tilts the hand down and back as well. So plenty of movement in there. And again, that'll be the same on the other side. Excellent. That's a nice little piece of articulation. I did not think that I had that there. So hard to see. The waist, the upper torso, plenty of swivel kind of movement on that. You can almost see that peg in there. It's just popping out almost. We do get, I believe, no, we do not. No swivel waist on this figure. It seems kind of glued in. It may be that this figure's new, but it seems glued in. We do get up at the top, holy moly, this thing has ball joint. Wow, there you go. Ball jointed hips on this thing. I could have laid money this was going to be swivel hips, but ball jointed hips on this. Wow, this is pretty excellent. Ball joints on the knees and rocking ankles as well, plus, of course, peg holes. That's a much better figure than I at first thought. Really lots of articulation. Probably hence why this guy is one of the most in-demand figures from this range. So, excellent looking figure overall. I really do like this one. Love to know your thoughts though. What do you think, Commander Wolf, in this design? Do you bother about the articulation? Do you just want them in 5 points of articulation? I know some of you do. But yeah, love to hear your thoughts on this figure, its design, its aesthetics. Please do leave a comment below. We'll have a bit of a conversation on Commander Wolf. And that's it for this figure. If, again, you want to buy it, click a link below. If you want to subscribe, we've got plenty of other videos that come straight into your inbox. All you got to do, click subscribe, you'll get an email, you'll see a video. That's it. We'll be back with more reviews, and we'll see you then. Cheers.